It's a great honor and privilege for me to be part of this celebration of the 30-year anniversary of the church in Sacramento.
Moja porodica i ja se zahvaljujemo crkvi u Sakramentu, crkvenom odboru i vašem pastoru Saši Anđelkoviću na upućenom pozivu da budemo ovog vikenda sa vama.
And we are expressing our gratitude as a family to your church and to your pastor for inviting us to be with you this weekend.
Pa evo odmah na početku da vam poželim srećan 30. rođendan.
So let me wish you happy 30th birthday at the very beginning.
Neka vas Gospod blagoslovi i da dočekate mnoge nove jubileje u radosti, zdravlju i miru.
And may God bless you and may you see many other jubilees in good health and filled with peace. Yeah.
30. godine u životu čoveka su period kada osoba ulazi u razdoblje zrelosti.
When we reach 30, being 30 years old, we reach the level of maturity or the period of maturity.
Tako je. Znači, ostavljamo iza sebe dečije bolesti.
So we leave behind us childish diseases.
Pubertetske ispade.
Puberty and the access that comes with it.
I adolescentske krize identiteta.
And adolescent identity crisis.
30. godine su godine snage i produktivnosti.
30 year old is a time of energy and productivity.
Ali isto i vreme kada život počinje da shvatamo u svoj njegovoj ozbiljnosti.
But also a time when we start taking life seriously.
Kada se suočavamo sa teretima odgovornosti i isto tako osjećajem neizvesnosti za budućnost koja dolazi.
When at that time we start feeling the burden of responsibility as well as uncertainty because of the future that's in front of us.
I možda kao crkva u Sakramentu se pitamo šta će biti sa nama za 10, 20, 30 godina?
And maybe as a church in Sacramento we are thinking what's going to happen to us in 10, 20 or 30 years.
I to je jedna velika odgovornost.
And that's a huge responsibility.
Naslov teme za ovo jutro je nemamo se čega bojati osim.
My title for this morning is we have nothing to fear unless.
Ovaj naslov je deo preuzet iz citata sestre White.
And I borrow this from the quote of Ellen White.
I to je jedan poznati citat koji ću ja ovako grubo prevesti sa engleskog na naš jezik.
And it's a very well known quote that I will try to translate for you.
Sestre White je pisala: mi se nemamo čega bojati za budućnost osim ako zaboravimo kako nas je Gospod vodio u prošlosti i njegova učenja.
We have nothing to fear about the future unless we forget how God led us in the past and we forget his teaching.
Ove reči također možemo da nađemo i u Svetom pismu na mnogim mestima. I ja bih otvorila zajedno sa vama 5. Mojsijevu, 7. poglavlje, 1. 17. i 18. stih.
And we can find this in the scripture in many places, and I'd like to open up the book of Deuteronomy, chapter 7, verses 1:17 and 18.
Evo daću vam par momenata da pronađete stih i čitat ćemo zajedno.
So let us read together.
5. Mojsijeva, 7. glava, 1. 17. i 18. stih.
So Deuteronomy chapter 7, verses 1:17 and 18. If somebody sees my English Bible in the back, bring it to me. Yes. Yeah, that's mine. Yes, please.
Evo šta Božja reč kaže. Kada te Gospod Bog tvoj uvede u zemlju u koju ideš, da je naslediš, i otere ispred tebe narode mnoge. Stih 17. Ako bi rekao u srcu svom, veći su svi ovi narodi od mene, kako ih mogu izagnati? Ne boj ih se. I sada, kako to da ih se ne bojim kad su oni veći od mene? Zato što pamti dobro što je učinio Gospod Bog tvoj s Faraonom i sa svim misircima.
So it reads, when the Lord your God brings you into the land which you go to possess and has cast out many nations before you, the Hittites and the Girgashites and the Amorites and the Canaanites and the Perizzites and the Hivites and the Jebusites, seven nations greater and mightier than you. If you should say in your heart, these nations are greater than I, how can I dispossess them? You shall not be afraid of them. And this is how we will not be afraid. It says, but you shall remember well what the Lord God, your God, did to Pharaoh and to all Egypt.
Znači, Boži savjet za nas je kada se suočavamo sa budućnošću, Gospod želi zapravo da se okrenemo ka prošlosti i tamo pronađemo novu snagu i motivaciju da suočimo tu budućnost ne sa strahom, nego sa pouzdanjem u Boga.
So God's will for us that as we are facing the uncertain future, he wants us to remember the past.
Šta bi to značilo za našu crkvu ovdje u Sacramentu i u Severnoj Americi?
What would that mean for our church in Sacramento and North America?
To bi značilo da pamtimo Božje vodstvo i blagoslove u proteklom periodu.
That would mean to remember God's blessings from the past.
Drugim rečima, da se prisjećamo istorije naše crkve.
In other words, to remember the history of our church.
Njenih početaka, izazova, čudesnih blagoslova.
Their beginnings, challenges and wondrous blessings.
I puta kojim nas je Bog doveo do ovog trenutka gdje smo sad.
And we should remember the path that God led us by to this place.
Da se sećamo ljudi koji su gradili i vodili ovu crkvu za nas.
To remember people who were building and leading this church for us.
Da prepričavamo anegdote koje uključuju ono što su se oni žrtvovali da bismo mi imali ovo što sada imamo.
To tell anecdotes about their sacrifice for what we are having today.
Da se prisjećamo i nanovo ponavljamo Božje odgovore na naše molitve kao zajednice.
To remember and rehearse God's response to our prayers as a community.
Ali isto tako da ne zaboravljamo i naše padove, nego da izvučemo korisne pouke za naš današnji život i za budućnost.
But in the same way to remember times when we stumbled and to learn from it so that we wouldn't repeat that in the future.
So ovih nekoliko narednih trenutaka želela bih posvetiti posebno ovoj temi, a to je očuvanje istorije našeg naroda.
So I would like to use next few moments to talk to you about the preservation of the history of our people.
Postoji nekoliko razloga zašto je to važno i već smo mogli da vidimo iz citata od sestre White iz 5. Mojsijeve koliko je to važno za nas.
There are several reasons why that is so important and we've seen it already from the Ellen White's quote.
Jedan od prvih razloga zašto je važno pamtiti, čuvati, prenositi istoriju naše crkve mlađim pokolenjima je očuvanje i izgradnja hrišćanskog adventističkog identiteta.
First reason why we need to remember our history is that we would develop a Christian Adventist identity in the hearts of our young people.
Biti hrišćanin danas je sve manje popularno, čak i ovdje u Severnoj Americi gdje je hrišćanstvo tradicionalna religija.
Today, being a Christian is less and less popular, especially here in North America.
Even here.
Even here, yeah. Like in the Christian country.
That's
right,
yes. Stručnjaci kažu da je jedan od najvećih razloga za to što ljudi gube osjećaj pripadnosti, odnosno gube identitet hrišćanski.
And experts tell us that one of the main reasons for that is that people lose their identity and the feeling of belonging.
Šta je to identitet?
What is identity?
Identitet određuje kome ili čemu pripadamo.
identity defines who we are and who we belong to.
Određuje čije vrednosti sledimo u životu.
Defines whose values we are following in our lives.
Identitet određuje čime se najviše poistovećujemo ili saživljavamo u životu.
It determines what we associate with and become one with in our life.
Jedan jako očigledan primjer kako identitet izgleda u praksi su sportski navijači.
One very obvious example how identity looks in real life is people who are, how do we call them? Fans, sports fans, thank you.
U Srbiji, odakle ja dolazim, ja pamtim, to su tradicionalno zvezdaši i partizanovci.
In Serbia, where I come from, those are Zvezdaši and Partizanovci, which is two rival teams, soccer teams.
To je nešto što ljudi žive dan i noć i za te utakmice, to se ne spava, to se živi i gine.
People live for it day and night and they're willing to die for the match.
Za nas koji volimo tenis i pogotovo koji živimo izvan naše matične zemlje, Novak Đoković bi bio neko s kim bismo se mi možda želeli ili poistovećivali.
For those of us who live outside of our country and who love tennis, perhaps Novak Djokovic is somebody that we identify with.
Kad Novak pobeđuje, mi pobeđujemo.
When Novak is winning, we are all winning.
Kad neko nešto kaže lošo o Novaku, mi se naljutimo.
If somebody speaks bad about Novak, we get angry.
Kao pravi fanovi, mi se poistovećamo ili identifikujemo sa onim koga podržavamo.
Like true fans, we are identifying with those that we are supporting.
Nekima nije teško da ustanu ni u 3 ujutru samo da bi pratili utakmicu iz prve.
For many it's not hard even to wake up at 3 a.m. just to follow the match.
To je identitet, ono sa čime se saživljavamo i poistovećujemo.
That's what the identity is, something that we become one with.
E sada kao hrišćani, kao adventisti, to je identitet koji mi treba da imamo, da usvojimo.
And now we as Seventh-day Adventists should adopt the same kind of identity.
To bi trebalo da bude ono najvažnije za šta živimo i postojimo.
That should be what is the most important for us and what we live for and why we exist.
Pitanje je sada kako se identitet izgrađuje i očvršćava.
So the question is now how do we develop identity and make it stronger?
Hajde da se vratimo petoj knjizi Mojsijevoj i ovog puta ćemo čitati tekstove iz 6. glave.
Let's go back to the book of Deuteronomy and we're going to read from chapter 6.
Celo 6. poglavlje je odličan primjer, prepun savjeta kako se izgrađuje identitet Božjeg naroda.
And the whole chapter 6 is a very good example and advice as to how to develop and build the identity of God's people.
Mi ćemo pročitati nekoliko stihova i počet ćemo od 1. do 7. stiha.
We're going to read several verses from 1 through 7.
Ovo su zapovesti i uredbe i zakoni koje Gospod Bog vaš zapovedi da vas učim da ih tvorite u zemlji u koju idete da je nasledite.
Now this is the commandment and these are the statutes and judgments which the Lord your God has commanded to teach you that you may observe them in the land which you are crossing over to possess.
I onda stihovi od 2. do 6. govore da je koje su to zapovesti, ističu ljubav prema Bogu i bližnjemu kao suštinu svih Božjih zakona.
And then verses 2 through 6 are telling us how to do that and they are emphasizing love towards God and towards our neighbor as the way to achieve that.
I onda stih 7. Naglašava taj prvi aspekt kako se identitet izgrađuje i kaže.
And then verse 7 emphasizes this first aspect.
i često ih napominji sinovima svojim i govori o njima kada sediš u kući svojoj i kada ideš putem, kada ležeš i kada ustaješ.
You shall teach them diligently or frequently to your children and shall talk of them when you sit in your house, when you walk by the way, when you lie down and when you rise up.
Znači prvi pilar našeg adventističkog hrišćanskog identiteta su Božja učenja iz Svetog pisma.
So first pillar of our Christian or Adventist identity is God's teaching from the Holy Bible.
I Gospod kaže često ih napominji sinovima svojim i kćerima.
And God says mention them frequently to your children.
I ja verujem da u ovom aspektu kao zajednica trudimo se i radimo dobar posao sa našim mladima.
And I think that we are doing a pretty good job in this sense.
Međutim, postoji još jedan pilar, još jedna, ako bismo rekli, leva i desna noga da bi se zdravo hodilo, postoji još jedan oslonac koji je isto tako važan kao i ovaj prvi.
There is another pillar that's also very important, like a second leg, like a good footing that we need for this.
Čitaćemo stih 12 i još neke posle toga koji govore o toj drugoj strani.
We're going to read verse 12 and a few other verses that talk about it.
Čuvaj se da ne zaboraviš Gospoda koji te je izveo iz zemlje Misirske, iz kuće ropske.
Then beware lest you forget the Lord who brought you out of the land of Egypt from the house of bondage.
Stih 20. Pa kad te zapita posle sin tvoj govoreći, kakva su to svedočanstva i uredbe i zakoni što vam je zapovedio Gospod Bog vaš?
And then verse 20. When your son asks you in the time to come saying, what is the meaning of the testimonies, the statutes and the judgments which the Lord our God has commanded you?
To je ono kada nas naša deca pitaju, pa dobro, da li su ta učenja stvarno toliko važna?
That's when our children ask us, so are those teachings really that important?
Kakva to ima veza sa mojim svakodnevnim životom?
How does that intersect with my everyday life?
To su i deca iz biblijskih vremena pitala svoje roditelje. To nije ništa novo.
And we see that in the biblical times, that was the same question that children would ask their parents about.
I onda čitamo stihove 21. do 24. I kaže, onda kaži sinu svojemu.
And then verses 21 through 24, and it says, then you shall say to your son.
Hajde da sednemo i da imamo jednu dobru teološku raspravu.
Let us sit together and have a good theological discussion.
Što više citata iz Biblije, što više citata iz teologije i duha proroštva, filozofije.
As many verses from the Bible as possible, as many quotes from Ellen White from as possible, philosophy.
Pa da vidimo ko će koga da nadmudri.
And let's see who's gonna win the argument.
To nije ono što stih kaže.
That's not what the scripture is saying.
Hajde da vidimo šta piše.
Let's see what it says.
Stih 21.
So verse 21.
Onda kaže sinu svojemu, bijasmo robovi faraonovi u Misiru i izvede nas Gospod iz Misira rukom krepkom.
Then you shall say to your son, we were slaves of Pharaoh in Egypt, and the Lord brought us out of Egypt with a mighty hand.
I učini Gospod znake i čudesa velika i zla u Misiru na faraonu i na svemu domu njegovu pred njima, pred nama.
And the Lord showed signs and wonders before our eyes, great and severe against Egypt, Pharaoh and all his household.
A nas izvede odande da nas uvede u zemlju za koju se zakle ocima našim da će nam je dati.
Then he brought us out from there that he might bring us in to give us the land of which he swore to our fathers.
I zapovedi nam Gospoda vršimo sve ove uredbe, bojeći se Gospoda Boga svojega, da bi nam bilo dobro svagda i da bi nas sačuvao u životu kao što se i danas vidi.
And the Lord commanded us to observe all these statutes, to fear the Lord our God for our good always, that he might preserve us alive as it is this day.
Dakle, ako je prvi pilar, ako je prvi oslonac identiteta, poznavanje učenja hrišćanstva, učenja crkve.
So if the first pillar of our identity is teachings of our church,
šta je na osnovu ovog drugog dela šestog poglavlja, ovaj drugi oslonac, drugi pilar?
What is this second pillar based on these scriptures that we just read?
Jel bi neko želeo da kaže, šta mislite na osnovu ovih stihova? Neko je kazao experience, iskustvo, živo iskustvo sa Bogom.
So somebody said experience, which is a live experience with God.
To je ono kada uzmete svoje dete ili nekog mladu, ali i nekog novog, starijeg u crkvi, kažete da ti kažem šta je za mene Gospod učinio.
That's when you sit next to a child in a church and then tell them, let me tell you what the Lord did for me in my life.
Sad ću ti reći zašto mi kao zajednica činimo ovo što činimo.
I'm going to tell you why we as a community are doing what we are doing.
Zato što je Gospod bio dobar prema nama.
Because God was good to us.
Zato što nas je proveo kroz teška vremena pobedonosno.
Because he took us victoriously through hardships.
Zato što je odgovorio na naše molitve.
Because he answered our prayers.
I onda delimo konkretne primere tih iskustva.
And then we share concrete examples of those experiences.
To je ono što će da stvara i učvršuje jedan identitet.
And that's what builds and strengthens identity.
Jevrejski narod, tradicionalni Jevreji i dan danas imaju snažan osjećaj pripadnosti svojoj zajednici.
To this day, Jewish community has a very strong feeling of belonging to their community.
Dobro Jerusalima, dobro Božjeg naroda stavljaju ispred svoje lične sreće.
The destiny of Jerusalem they put above their personal happiness.
Pročitat ću dva stih iz Psalma 137.
I'm going to read two verses from Psalm 137.
Peti i šesti stih kažu,
verses 5 and 6.
Ako zaboravim tebe, Jerusalime, neka me zaboravi desnica moja.
If I forget you, O Jerusalem, let my right hand forget its skill.
Neka prione jezik moj za usta moja, ako tebe ne uspamtim, ako ne uzdržim Jerusalima svrh veselja svojega.
If I do not remember you, let my tongue cling to the roof of my mouth, if I do not exalt Jerusalem above my chief joy.
Doslovan prevod petog stiha bi bilo, ako zaboravim na tebe, Jerusalime, neka mi se osuši desna ruka.
A literal translation of the verse 5 says, if I would forget you, Jerusalem, may my hand becomes withered.
Ako kao hrišćani, ako kao adventisti zaboravimo ko smo, sve ostalo u životu postaje bez ikakve vrednosti i bez ikakvog smisla.
If we forget who we are as Adventists, everything else loses sense and purpose.
Tradicionalni Jevreji dan danas, na primjer, polome čašu na kraju svadbenog veselja.
Traditional Jews today break a glass at the end of the celebration.
Da simbolički pokažu da ni jedna sreća nije potpuna dok se Jerusalim ponovo ne zazida.
To show symbolically that no happiness is complete until Jerusalem is rebuilt.
Ili jedan drugi običaj je da ne ukrašavaju zid prema istoku u kući.
Or another custom is that they do not decorate eastern wall in their house.
Jer to je zid koji gleda prema Jerusalimu.
Because that's the wall looking towards Jerusalem.
On treba da ostane pust i prazan dokle god je Jerusalim pust i prazan.
He needs to remain desolate and empty as long as the Jerusalem is desolate and empty.
Identitet je nešto što živimo u svom životu.
Identity is something that we live in our lives.
I kao što vidimo, učenja i poznavanje naše istorije je nešto što će nas izgraditi u tom hrišćanskom adventističkom identitetu.
And as we can see, the teachings as well as the history of our church is something that will build and strengthen that identity.
Jedan drugi razlog zbog kojeg je važno da se opominjemo svoje istorije jeste da nas istorija inspiriše i ohrabruje.
Another reason why it is important for us to remember our history is that it's inspiring us and encouraging us.
Apostol Pavle, za kog verujemo da je pisao Jevrejima poslanicu, u 11. poglavlju Jevrejima poslanice i početak 12. glave Jevrejima poslanice, izlistava heroje vere iz Biblije.
You know, Apostle Paul, who we believe wrote the epistle to Hebrews in chapter 11, gives us a list of these heroes of faith.
I opominje se Avrama, Mojsija, Davida.
And he remembers Abraham, Moses, David.
I želi da kaže, to su sve ljudi koji su kao i mi bili ljudi od krvi i mesa, ali su verovali Bogu i Bog ih je blagoslovio.
And he wants to tell us that they were just normal people like us, but God blessed them in their lives because of their faith.
Ali mi ne smemo da steknemo utisak da heroji vere i Božja slava postoji samo u Bibliji.
It would be wrong to get an impression that the heroes of faith and God's glory exists only in the Bible.
Isus je rekao u Mateju 28. glavi, i gle, ja sam s vama u sve dane do svršetka veka.
Jesus said in the Gospel of Matthew chapter 28, and I will be with you all the days until the end of the world.
Heroji vere postoje sve ove vekove do današnjeg dana.
Heroes of faith existed throughout all the centuries to this day.
I naša je odgovornost da istražujemo i sačuvamo uspomenu na njih.
And it is our responsibility to keep researching and to preserve the memory of them.
Verujem, možda ste neki od vas čuli, možda ne, da na primjer istorija adventizma u Beogradu datira još od davne 1909. godine.
Maybe you have heard or not that the history of the Adventist Church in Belgrade dates back from 1909.
Prvi vernik bio je brat Gligorije Gliša Petrović.
The first church member was brother Gligorije Gliša Petrović.
Da je apostol Pavle živ, ja verujem da bi on uključio brata Glišu u 11. poglavlje Jevrejima poslanice.
So if the apostle Paul was alive, I believe that he would include brother Glisha within the chapter 11 of the epistle to Hebrews.
Ali ta odgovornost je na nama.
But that responsibility rests on us.
U kući brata Gliša okupljala se prva mala grupa adventističkih vernika.
In the house of brother Glisha, a first group of Adventist believers would gather regularly.
Koja se kasnije preselila u Žarkovo.
And later on they moved to the other part of the town.
Da bi se crkva koju danas znamo kao Božidarac zidala negde 1930-ih.
In order to build the church that we know today, Božidarađe, in 1930s.
I danas 2019. kada odemo u Božidarac, vidimo nekoliko stotina vernika.
And today when we go to that church in 2019, we see many hundreds of church members, believers.
Sve te stotine vernika su proizvod rada i žrtava heroja vere.
And all those hundreds of believers are a product and a product of sacrifice of those heroes of faith.
Ko su svi ti heroji vere?
Who are all those heroes of faith?
Pokušala sam da nađem informacije, nisam mogla.
I've tried to find information about them, but I just didn't, it didn't happen.
Malo smo o tome pisali.
We wrote very little about it.
Ali sada je vrijeme da uradimo nešto po tom
pitanju. But now is the time for us to do something about it.
Što se tiče istorije Svetske adventističke crkve, 1870. godine naša crkva imala 5000 krštenih vernika.
As far as the history of the Seventh-day Adventist Church at large, in 1870s our church had 5000 recorded members.
Prema statistikama iz 2017. Adventista u svetu ima 20,727,347.
According to the current statistics, there's 20,727,347 church members in
danas
the world.
Sigurno i taj broj je i 21 milion i više.
Since this is from 2017, today it's probably much more than that.
Postojali su heroji vere koji su crkvu od 5000 vernika doveli do preko 21 milion.
There were heroes of faith that brought the church from 5000 church members to 20 million church members.
To su ljudi kao vi i ja.
Those are people like you and I.
Koje ne smemo da zaboravimo.
That we should not forget.
Čiji primjeri nas ohrabruju da nastavimo Božje djelo.
Whose examples keep encouraging us to keep going.
Zbog ovih razloga adventistička crkva, svetska adventistička crkva sa sedištem u generalnoj konferenciji u Silver Springu je započela jedan važan projekat očuvanja istorije adventističke crkve u svetu.
For this reason, World Church, Seventh-day Adventist Church or a General Conference started this new project of preservation of the Adventist history.
Kao što je Saša već spomenuo, ja na tom projektu radim u svojstvu urednika.
And as Saša already mentioned, I work on that project as a manager, managing editor.
That's right, yes. I ceo svet, znači imamo preko 20 pomoćnih urednika u svakoj diviziji.
And we have also more than 20 editors in every division.
Koji su formirali istraživačke timove u svakoj uniji u diviziji.
Who formed the research teams in every division.
Želja je da se radi istraživanje i prikupljanje informacija iz svih knjiga, časopisa koji su nešto objavili.
It is our desire to collect all the articles or any information, published information about our history.
Ali jedan drugi zadatak je još važniji.
But there is even more important goal that we would like to reach.
A to je da se sačuva oralna tradicija, to je ono što se prepričava s kolena na koleno.
And that's to preserve the oral tradition or what people share with each other from one to another generation.
I dakle, vrše se intervjui sa ljudima koji, kada uskoro odu sa ovog sveta, sa njima će to znanje umreti.
So they're trying to interview people who are older and if they die, their knowledge will die with them.
Skupljaju se stara pisma, dnevnici.
Old letters are being collected, diaries.
Stari časopisi, fotografije.
Old articles, pictures,
crkveni buleteni, programi,
church bulletins and programs,
izveštaji sa crkvenih odbora koji sačuvaju mnoge odluke,
church board minutes that talk about many decisions,
čak i video zapisi koji postoje na onim starim trakama,
and also video materials,
koji se digitalizuju i sada su mogu biti dostupni.
And they're being transferred into a digital form so that they could be accessible to everybody.
Verujem da bi članak o istoriji jugoslovenske adventističke dijaspore u Severnoj Americi bio jedan važan projekat, važan članak za našu enciklopediju.
And I believe that an article on the history of the our church in diaspora, Yugoslavian diaspora would take an important place in this encyclopedia.
Taj članak može da napiše samo neko od nas, neko ko zaista voli i brine o tom aspektu naše crkve.
And that article can write only one of us who loves and cares about our church.
I koristim ovu priliku da apelujem na vas, da zapisujete ono što se dešava, da intervjuišete starije vernike dok se još uvek sećaju svega što se dešavalo, da imamo zapise o tome kako nas je Bog vodio.
And I appeal to you to work on it, to record what you know, to interview our older church members so that the memory wouldn't be forgotten.
Enciklopedija Hrišćanske adventističke crkve imaće preko 9000 članaka.
This Seventh-day Adventist encyclopedia will have over 9000 articles.
Fotografija i medija.
Photographs and media clips.
I prvo izdanje koje uz Božju pomoć planiramo da lansiramo za vrijeme zasjedanja generalne konferencije sljedeće godine u julu.
And the first edition that we are hoping to publish next year for the general conference session.
Biće online enciklopedija ili enciklopedija koja će biti na internetu.
So it's going to be an online encyclopedia accessible through internet.
Kasnije, najvjerovatnije 5 godina od danas, planiramo da odštampamo i knjigu u nekoliko tomova, ali naš glavni fokus je na online enciklopediji.
5 years from now, we plan to publish a book, several volumes, but our main goal is to make it accessible online.
Ova enciklopedija bit će jedan od efektivnih načina da nosimo Hrista svetu.
And this effort will be one of the effective means of taking Jesus to the world.
Posebno ova prva online enciklopedija, zato što su ljudi danas online.
Especially this online edition, because people are now online.
Biće dovoljno samo googlovati pojam i jedno čitavo bogatstvo tradicije naše biće ljudima dostupno.
It's going to be enough just to google up what we'd like to find out and we'll be able to share about our history.
Na kraju bih željela uputiti poziv svima nama koji možda direktno nećemo raditi na enciklopediji.
So I'd like to also extend an appeal to those who will not be directly involved in this.
Svi mi smo deo očuvanja istorije.
All of us are part of the preservation of history.
Roditelji, ne zaboravite da delite sa svojom decom, sa svojom crkvom, vaša živa iskustva sa
Parents,
Bogom.
Do not forget to share your personal testimony with your children.
Vaše Božje odgovore na vaše molitve.
God's answers to your prayers.
Podelite čak i vaše padove i iskušenja s naglaskom na to kako vas je Bog izbavio od njih.
Share also your shortcomings and temptations with an emphasis on how God delivered you from that.
To je nešto najvrednije što možete ostaviti novom naraštaju vaše deci.
That's something that's the most valuable that you can leave to the next generation.
Nedavno sam razgovarala sa jednom našom sestrom koja je prebegla iz Bosne za Australiju u vrijeme 90-ih za vrijeme rata.
I recently talked to one sister who migrated to Australia
during the 90s
and wars in our countries.
I u takvom razgovoru ona mi je rekla: Dragoslava, ono što mi je najžalije je što nisam uspjela da ponesem sa sobom album sa našim porodičnim slikama.
And she told me, what I'm really sad about is that I wasn't able to bring our family photo album.
Tu su slike, fotografije mojih roditelja, moje fotografije sa venčanja, moje dece dok su bili mali.
We had pictures of my parents and
wedding
mm-hmm. and our children when they were little.
Ona nije rekla tako mi je žao što ne ponesoh onaj televizor.
She didn't say, oh, I'm so sad that I didn't bring TV with me.
Oni su ostavili sve, ali sve to drugo, daje Bog i snagu i okolnosti, zaradilo se i nadomestilo se.
They left everything behind, but all those things, you know, because God gives strength and opportunities, they were able to earn money and to replenish what they needed.
Ali uspomene.
But memories.
To se nikad ne može zameniti, nadoknaditi.
You cannot replace that with anything. Thank you.
Draga deco, pitajte svoje roditelje, bake i deke o njihovim iskustvima sa Bogom.
Dear children, ask your parents and your grandparents about their experience with God.
Naši roditelji neće zauvek biti sa nama.
Our parents won't be with us forever.
I sada je prilika da uhvatimo sve te memorije, jer to je nešto što će nas držati i hrabriti kroz život.
And now is the time to capture all those memories. That's something that's going to keep us together and give us strength.
Mi se nemamo čega bojati za budućnost.
We have nothing to fear about the future.
Osim.
Unless.
Osim ako zaboravimo kako nas je Gospod vodio u prošlosti i njegovo učenje.
Unless we forget how God led us in the past and his teachings.
Neka nas Gospod sve blagoslovi.
May God bless us all. Amen. Thank you.
Hvala.